Hi, my name is Jason Kang. I'm a full stack developer working in South Korea. And today we're going to build the area called Nav. We have finished the header of our block so far, but we have a problem. Well, not really a problem, but Medium updated their design, so we cannot use the header anymore. But I think it was definitely worth it because now you have the basic understanding of the flexbox. Today, we're going to build the area called Nav using the flexbox that we have learned. The Nav tag represents the set of navigation links, which means that it's going to have 8 tags as its children. And I've downloaded some images and put them into the image directory. You can download some free images or free icons using Google so that you can use them for your project as well. And if you look at this, I'm going to go build this area. And with the flexbox, I'm going to separate them into 3 different sections. The first, second, and last. So let's do that. Icon names here. It's home, notifications, list, story, and write. Let's also get rid of the styles, except the body. Notifications. Oops. List. And then story. Right. Profile. Oh, you don't see anything here. That is because we have not set the width and height of our images. So let's get that. I'm going to set them to 24 pixels each. We have them. And they are in some horizontal line. That is because they are not block properties. So I'm going to set the class names to it and then set them display block. Let's also add class name to our nav bar. To the links. And get them everywhere. Oops. Like that. And then there we go. And then let's also add the flexbox to our nav. Flex direction, horizontal column. Justify content space between. If you remember justify content space between, it puts the first item towards the beginning of the flex line. I mean the flex direction, last item towards the end, and everything else is spaced in between evenly. There we have it. Oops, what's going on? That is because this doesn't have the height information. So I'm going to set body to take up the entire height. And then the nav bar to take up the entire height itself of the the nav bar to take up the height of the body. There we go. So now let's get the spacings in between. If you look at this, from the top it's 40 pixels, from the bottom is 16 pixels, and everything else is spaced by 35 pixels. Right, let's take a look from the top. 35. So let's do that. Padding would be 35. Like that. So I've set the space, but you see that you gotta scroll down to see the last item. That is because the bodies take up more height or more space than is visible in the browser. So I'm going to use a special property and set the height of the nav bar so that it takes up the only space that is visible on the browser. And now we have the items. Then let's space the items in the between. Let's set class name. And then use the flexbox again. If you remember, the gap was 35 pixels. There we go. Well, if you take a look at the blog again, there's a tiny line in between. So let's get that color as well. If you look at this, the colors, this one right here. So instead of using the HR tag, I'm gonna set the border to the last item, and you just select or call last child to increase the space between the fourth item and the last item. There we go. And you see that it's taking up the entire browser width. That is because we have not set the width to the navbar. So let's get that information. So if you take a look at this, you can see the width of the navbar is 80 pixels. So let's get that information. And let's align them at the center. And now let's add the border to this area right here. The border would be right here. Let's set. There we have the nav bar. And that's it for today. And I'm going to deploy this project to our Naver Cloud platform so you can check it out using the URL that we provide. And as always, if you want to learn something specific, just leave them in the comments below so I can answer your questions. Thank you and stay tuned.